Well, my husband was a car dealer, and we had a beautiful house in Burlingame.
Donna Price felt like she had it all, until all of a sudden, she didn't.
We sold our house to save our business and put all the money into it, and we lost the business and all the money.
Price says she spent years just feeling stuck in the same dark thoughts.
It's hard to keep going and just searching for or worrying about what's going to happen next. And are we going to be able to survive?
Well, most people don't have challenges as big as Donna's. It turns out getting stuck on any negative news is pretty universal.
When I was trying to get tenure and my life revolved entirely around publishing papers, I would get a paper rejected and that would stick with me for, you know, a week or two or three. And then sometimes I would get a paper accepted, fortunately, and that would be really nice for about a day.
Dr. Allison Ledgerwood started wondering why this setback stayed with her so much longer, and many others may wonder too. The UC Davis social psychology professor has 4 million views for an online speech describing her research into how people process negative information.
To test them, she framed information in positive and negative ways. In one experiment, having two groups of people and telling them about a new procedure. She told one group it had a 70% success rate. For the other group, they were told 30% of the people died. Well, the same number here, framed in two different ways, and the folks who got the positive spin loved the procedure. With the negative spin, they didn't.
And that's something we knew before from a lot of research across the behavioral sciences, that simple ways of wording things can have a kind of dramatic effect on how people think about them. But unlike previous research, we didn't stop there, we kept going.
For that next step, each group got the other example. So those who started with the positive view were told about the 30% mortality rate. At that point, they changed their minds. They no longer thought that surgery was a good idea. Those who started with the negative view were told about the 70% success rate. And here's where it got interesting. They didn't change their minds. They still didn't like the surgery.
In another study, people got a simple math problem. Converting a positive number to a negative was quick, an average of 7 seconds. But to convert from a negative to a positive, it was 11 seconds. It was just harder for most people to think that way. Dr. Ledgerwood repeated these experiments in various ways and again found most people naturally tend toward the negative and get stuck there.
I think the biggest lesson that I take away from this research for my own life is that it actually takes more work to see the positive side of things than it does to see the negative side of things. Our minds might be built to look for negative information and hold on to it once we find it.
So then the question becomes, how do we get unstuck? And for that, let's go back to Donna.
It's every day I'm grateful.
Donna says she is truly happy now, but it's taken this kind of work.
If something bad happens, I try to tell myself that is, you know, you don't have to be down about it. You can be positive. And the more I do that, the easier it is. And it just, like I said, becomes a habit that I choose to be positive and happy.
There's a large body of scientific research that backs up what Donna was able to do by instinct. If you want to put this into practice, think of 3 things you're grateful for every day. It sounds simple, and it is, but the Greater Good Science Center at UC Berkeley has research from around the world showing a strong connection to greater well-being.
So I would measure before any of these exercises how people were doing in terms of well-being, in terms of physical symptoms like muscle aches or stomach discomfort, and show that after engaging in these gratitude practices, their scores all moved in a positive direction.
Donna didn't need science to understand the benefits, but she did need discipline to come this far.
It's a choice I make because my life is better if I choose to be positive.